only on Fox Business.
All right, back with Minister Jonathan Gentry. And Jonathan, I know you can't see what we're about to show. We're showing the St. Louis Rams when they came out for their game this past weekend with their arms raised. There was no punishment exacted by the NFL, even though a number of police associations were upset. And then a number of House members this past week did the same thing on the floor of the House, mimicking that. What do you think of that? No harm done, no foul, what?
No harm. However, man, your job is to play football. You didn't have to come out acting like that. I mean, honestly, you know, that's just my opinion. Go make a touchdown and try to win a game. Okay, don't come out with that foolishness.
Do you think there's a heightened pressure, Reverend? And we got into this the other night, that on public figures, maybe even to the president, who met with Al Sharpton, tried to do the right thing, met with all these community leaders, the criticism when he met with like-minded folks who agreed, as he did, that this decision, this grand jury decision, wasn't what he wanted it to be. But having said that, do you think there is a higher bar for those in leadership, whether in office or just by stature, to not fan the flames?
Absolutely. Eric Holder, sir, you don't need to hold a meeting about racial profiling. You need to sit down with those community leaders that you sat with in that church that I believe in, it was in Atlanta. You need to tell them to clean up the neighborhood. That's what I would have spoke to you about. If I was Obama, that's what I would have told you. You all are here today. They're serving you tea and crackers. Let's change our communities. Let's do that. Okay? Let's go 6 months without killing each other. And then come back to me and we'll discuss change. If I was sitting down with these people, you understand? Because I'm not going to point fingers when I'm sitting down with a group of people that need changing themselves. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to start with you first. You understand? That's where our problem is. People don't want to look in the mirror. That reflection in the mirror makes that pain turn realer. And that's what people don't want to look at.
Then why weren't you at that meeting? You got more hits on YouTube than probably all those various reverends or whoever else was there combined. But you're not there. And you sound like a perfectly amiable enough guy where you would hear all sides. You'd speak your mind, but you'd hardly be bigoted about it. So why isn't that point of view, however you feel about it, shared in either the mainstream or at meetings such as this?
I'll be honest with you, Neil. I'm going to be straightforward. Darkness hates light. Plain and simple. Darkness hates light. And what's happening is, like I call it the Medusa spirit. The black community has a Medusa spirit. Medusa was a bad mamma jamma. You couldn't tell her nothing. But what was her weakness? When you held a mirror in her face. Whoa, yikes. That's all I'm doing. Take a look at yourself before you want to point the finger at anyone else. Rather be the police department, the white man, or anyone else. The murder rate in our own communities are through the ceiling. Okay, like Jolly Green Giant, okay? Jack and a Beanstalk, it is high. We need to bring that low before we could say anything to a police department from all over the country. Let's bring down our murder rates in our communities first. I'm starting with us first. Even the Bible tells you in Peter, judgment must first start in the house of God. He's starting with you first. You want me to judge Darren Wilson? You want me to judge them? You want me to do that? You want me to do this? Okay, I'm gonna do that, but however, I'm gonna do you first. Starts with you. Change starts with you. That's all I'm pushing. I'm moving under God's authority, his wisdom, his power, his might, his anointing, and the Holy Spirit, plain and simple.
Minister, I want to thank you very much. Thank you for indulging us for so long.
God bless you, Neil. Thank you for having me.
But I thought a lot of you folks at home, since you don't hear this much in the media, and since we, including on this show and other shows, have heard the other side ad nauseum, we felt obligated to present another side. There is another point of view. We're not asking you, as the minister wasn't asking you, to buy what he says, but to at least hear what he says. That is the essence of fair and balance, because it's not black or white. It's us. It's all of us. We'll have more after this.